will start recording and then I will share the screen. Okay. So, let us start with the lecture, students. Okay. So today we are going to study the pinout of 8051. Okay. So, so here you can observe the pin description of 8051, and in this diagram you can observe that 8051 is a 40 pin IC, 20 pin to our left side and 20 pins to our right side. Okay, so let us study the pin out and its function, its related function, one by one. I think we have studied these pins, is it? Yes, answer me whether we have studied these pins. No. So let us start with the pin number 40 is plus VCC pin, and at this pin you can connect the positive of the power supply, and 8051 requires plus 5 volt DC voltage for its operation. Okay, and pin number 20 is the ground pin. That means between pin number 40 and pin number 20 we have to connect a power supply of 5 volt DC. Okay, now the next two pins, as it shows, pin number 19 and pin number 18. Okay, so here you can observe pin number, this is what is pin number 18 and this is pin number 19. So pin number 19 is X2 and pin number 18 is X1. So these two are the pins between which we are going to connect the external crystal, quartz crystal of frequency 12 megahertz. Okay, and even you can connect external oscillator if you want. So if you want to use internal oscillator for clock generation, then what you have to do is you have to connect a quartz crystal of value 12 megahertz between pin number 18 and pin number 19, and along with these two pins connected with quartz crystal, we have to connect 30 picofarad capacitors each to X1 and to X2. Okay, so that means if I want to draw a diagram, how it will be, it will be something like this. So between these two there will be a crystal. This is what I am showing with a small rectangular piece. It is a symbol of the crystal, and we have to connect the 30 picofarad capacitors to pin number X1 and also to pin number X2, like this. I think we can draw a bigger figure, so we can draw it. Suppose this is your 8051. What it is? It is a 8051. So here I can type 8051. Okay. Now suppose there are two pins here. One is X1. Okay. So this is X1, and one more pin is there, which is called as X2. X2 pin is there, and to these two pins, what we have to do is we have to connect a crystal between these two points, and here you can observe that we can draw a crystal. You can draw this circuit in your notebook. Always you have to bring the notebooks. Shraddha Kalani, she was in the waiting room. And here you have to connect what is called as capacitor. Okay, so let us connect capacitors here. So value of this capacitor, this shows a ground point. Okay, so here also you can connect a capacitor and connect this to ground. Okay, so value of this each capacitor is 30 picofarad. Okay, so these capacitors are used in order to reduce the noise related with this. Okay, now if you want to connect the external quartz crystal, so frequency of this quartz crystal, it may be between 4 megahertz to 30 megahertz, but mostly 8051 is operating at 12 megahertz. Okay, so you can also connect the external clock generator or external clock circuit. And when you want to connect the external clock circuit, then you have to connect it to a point X1, that is pin number 18, and you have to leave the pin number 19, that is X2, open. Okay, so this is what is regarding pins X1 and X2 of 8051. So what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story is that pin number X1 and X2, namely 18 and 19, they are used for oscillator. If you want internal oscillator, then you have to connect a circuit as shown in this diagram along with the external quartz crystal ranging from 4 megahertz to 30 megahertz, and you can use your internal built-in oscillator for clock generation. If you want external circuit to connect to the 8051, you have to use pin number 18, that is X1, and you can connect the external circuit to this pin number 18, and you have to leave pin number 19 open. Okay, so this is how we are using this pin number 19 and 18. So are you clear about this? Shall we move to next? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
So let us move to next. Okay. So I think I have to remove this. Okay, now here which pin you can observe? Yes, students, which pin you can observe here? Here, which pin you can observe? Please tell me.
Reset pin.
Huh? Reset pin, RST pin. What is function of this reset pin? Do you remember? What is function of the reset pin? The function of the reset pin is to apply the reset signal to 8051. Okay? So you have to apply reset signal to this pin, and this is pin number 9. Okay, and how this reset signal must be? This reset signal must be active high. That means you have to apply a logic 1 to RST pin when you want to apply the reset signal. Otherwise, you have to ground this pin when you are not resetting the microcontroller. That means during the normal operation of the microcontroller, you have to connect this pin to the ground. Ground means logic 0. And when you want to apply the reset signal to 8051, you have to apply logic 1 voltage at this pin number 9. And there is one condition. Okay. And what that condition is, this reset signal must be high for at least 2 machine cycles. Then and then only this reset signal will be activated, otherwise it will not be activated. Okay, so as all of you know, one machine cycle of 8051 consists of 12 clock pulse. That means your reset signal should be present at pin number 9 for 24 clock pulses. That is two machine cycles. Then only the reset signal will be activated. Now, what happens when the reset signal is applied to 8051 microcontroller? When reset signal is applied to 8051 microcontroller, whatever the values recently the resistor has, all those values will be lost, and all resistor will contain their default value. Mostly these default values are zero, but in some cases there are some finite values which we are going to study ahead. Otherwise, all remaining values will be 00H. That means you are initializing your microcontroller when you are applying the reset signal to microcontroller. Okay, so are you clear about this? The reset pin is pin number 9. To this reset pin, you can apply a reset signal for two clock pulses. It is active high pin, and when this signal is applied, the all contents of resistor will be lost, or they will contain the default value. Okay, and this whenever this pin is not to be used, or when you are operating at 051 normally, you have to connect it to ground, that is logic 0. Are you clear about this, students? Yes, respond me. Shall we move further? Shall we move further? Yes, I think. So here you can observe pin number 31 is EA pin. And here I have written slash EA. This is slash means active low. So generally how we write this? EA over which we have to write a bar. EA bar. So you can read this as EA bar. Okay, so this bar shows this pin is also active low. Meaning of EA is external access. Okay, so when you apply logic zero signal, or when you connect this pin to ground, then this signal will be activated. And when this signal is activated, what is the meaning of this? The external access is allowed. That means your program is stored in the external ROM. So whenever capacity of the built-in ROM or built-in RAM is not sufficient for a particular application, you are allowed to use the external ROM or external RAM. So in this case, you have to connect the EA pin to ground. Okay, so when you connect EA pin to ground, that means it indicates that your code is stored in the external program memory or read-only memory. Okay, so next pin is PSEN bar. So this is also a active low pin. That means this is active when it is at logic zero, or when it is connected to ground. The long form of PSEN is that program store enable. And when you are using the external read-only memory, you have to connect this PSEN signal to the output enable signal of read-only memory. So whenever 8051 want to access code from external ROM, so microcontroller will send a logic zero signal on PSEN to access the code that is stored in external read-only memory or the program memory. So this is what is the function of the PSEN. So what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story is that EA pin and PSE pin both are active low. They are used when you are using external memory, and when you want to access the external memory, both the pins should be at logic zero, and your PSEN should be connected to output enable pin of the read-only memory. Okay, so this is what is summarized thing. Now let us move to the next pin, and here we are going to study the pin number 30. And the pin number 30 is ALE. Where it is? Can you observe in the diagram? Yes, students. Can you observe it in the diagram? Yes, where it is? So here you can observe there is a pin. ALE. Okay. So what is long form of the pin ALE? What is the long form of the pin ALE? Can anybody tell me? You can observe it on the screen. Okay. What is written over there? What is the long form? Yes, please tell me. It is nothing but the address latch enable. Address latch enable. Okay. And how is this pin? This pin is active high. That means in order to make it active, you have to connect it to the logic 1. Okay. So 8051 port 0. Here you should know the dual functionality of port 0. Okay. So we have studied there are 4 parallel ports in 8051. P0, P1, P2, P3. Out of which P1 has only single function. And remaining ports P0, P2, P3, they have dual functions. Dual functions means it has 2 functions. And for port 0, the 2 functions are, one is it can be used for input-output operation, which is its default function. And the second function is that this port number 0 carries both address and data when you connect the external memory to 8051. So it carries both address as well as data on the same pins. Okay. So when you are carrying 2 types of signals on the same pins, this concept is called as multiplexing. So in case of 8051, port 0 outputs address and data of memory in multiplexed fashion. That means initially it will output the address and then after some time it will output the data. Okay. So here 8051 has to store, it has to store the address somewhere so that it can access the data when it is outputted by 8051 microcontroller or the memory unit. Okay. So this communication is two-way communication. So generally address is provided by 8051. Okay. And data may be provided by memory or it may be provided by 8051 depending on whether a particular memory operation is a read operation or a write operation. When there is a write operation, data travels from 8051 to memory. And when it is a read operation, data travels from memory to 8051. Okay. Now, here the pin ALE is used to demultiplex the address and data signals. That to demultiplex address and data signals means what? That means to separate out the address and data signals. The ALE pin is used to separate out the data and address signals. So this function of separating address and data signals is called as demultiplexing. And this demultiplexing is carried out along with the device which is called as a latch. All of you know what latch is. Yes, anybody can tell me what the latch is?
Lock.
Latch is lock. Correct. You are using with the door, isn't it? Once you close the door with the latch, the door gets locked. Okay. Similarly, this is a device which is used to lock the data or which is used to store the data. Okay. So, as I told you, initially during some initial clock pulses, 8051 outputs the address. Address shows the location where data is to be stored or the location from which data is to be retrieved. Okay, so this location is initially outputted by 8051 for certain duration of the time. Okay, so before lapse of this time, what has to be done? This address value has to be stored somewhere, and it is stored in what is called as the latch device. Okay, so initially what happens when address latch enable is used? Okay, when address latch enable is made one, the address which is present on the address bus or port 0 of 8051 will be stored into the latch. And once the address is stored into the latch, after at the end of this operation, what is done is the ALE pin is made low. And when this ALE pin is made low, 8051 outputs data on the port 0. Okay, and now 8051 will take the data and send it to the memory at the location whose address is stored in the latch. Okay, are you getting the point? म्हणजे पहिल्यांदा 8051 काय करतो, तर सेमच पोर्ट वापरला जातो. बघा, ऍड्रेस आउट करायला आणि डेटा पण आउट करायला. जेव्हा ऍड्रेस आउट केला जातो तेव्हा काय केलं जातं? एएलई जे असतं ते वन केलं जातं. ते वन केल्यानंतर काय होतं? तुमचा जो लॅच आहे तो एनेबल होतो, आणि जो काही ऍड्रेस तुमच्या पोर्ट झिरो वरती प्रेझेंट आहे तो त्या लॅच मध्ये स्टोअर होतो. आणि लॅच मध्ये स्टोअर झाल्यावरती एएलई पिन काय केली जाते? झिरो केली जाते. आणि मग जेव्हा एएलई पिन झिरो केली जाते तेव्हा काय केलं जातं? मायक्रो कंट्रोलर आता डेटा आउटपुट करतो. मग मायक्रो कंट्रोलर जो डेटा आउटपुट करतो तो डेटा आयदर मेमरीला राईट ऑपरेशनसाठी पाठवला जातो, किंवा जो मेमरी मध्ये डेटा आहे त्या पर्टिक्युलर लोकेशनला तो 8051 रीड करतो, डिपेंडिंग ऑन वेदर दिस ऑपरेशन इज रीड ऑपरेशन और राईट ऑपरेशन. सो डी मल्टीप्लेक्सिंग प्रोसेस वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन डिटेल आफ्टरवर्ड्स, बट ऍट दिस पॉइंट यू कॅन से दॅट ALE पिन इज ऍड्रेस लॅच एनेबल पिन, इट इज ऍक्टिव्ह हाय पिन अँड इट इज यूज्ड टू डी मल्टीप्लेक्स द ऍड्रेस अँड डेटा बस on port 0 of 8051 when the external memory is interfaced to 8051. Are you clear about this? Yes, respond quickly. Or do you have any difficulty in this, any doubt in this? You can ask me. But I think this is a simple point. At this point, you have to just remember ALE is address latch enable active high, and it is used to demultiplex the address and data bus, which is present on the port 0 of 8051. Okay? Are you clear? Shall we move forward?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, the next pins we are going to study are input, output, port pins. Okay, so how many input, output, port pins are there? Can anybody tell me input, output, port pins? Yes, how many pins are there? Can anybody tell me how many pins are there? How many ports are there, students? How many parallel ports are there? Tell me.
Four.
Four. So each port has how many pins? Tell me.
Eight.
Eight pins. That means four ports will have how many pins? How many pins?
32.
8 multiplied by 4 is equal to 32. So here I will show you the different ports on your pinout. Okay, to your left side you have port number 1, then there is a reset pin, and then we have port number 3. So these are odd ports which are present at the left side, and even ports are present on the right side. So initially you have port number 0 and then you have port number 2. So between these two ports there are some signals EA, ALE and PSEN. Now you can get, it is easy to draw the pin out because 32 pins are port pins. Okay, so here how nomenclature is given to the port pin, you can observe here P1.0. What is the meaning of P1.0? Port number 1, pin number 0. Port number 1, pin number 1. Port number 1, pin number 2. Port number 1, pin number 3. Like this, port number 1 and pin number 7. Okay. Now, if it is P0.5, what is meaning of that? Can anybody tell me? What is meaning of P0.5? Can anybody tell me? What is meaning of the P0.5? Yes, yes, yes.
Port number 0, pin number 5.
Correct. Port number 0, pin number 5. This is very, very important when you are going to perform bit operations on this. Okay. So this is particularly important for writing the programs. So similarly here you can observe port number 2 and etc. Okay. So there are 4 parallel ports and each port uses 8 pins. And how all these ports are? They are bidirectional. They can transmit data in both directions. Okay. So this is particularly useful for reading as well as writing of the data. And here I have told you port number 1 is a single function port. It doesn't handle any dual functionality. So it has only one function. Remaining ports P0, P2 and P3. Okay, they are dual function ports. Okay, P0 is also a dual function port. So the first function of port 0 is, it is used for input output operation. This is its first function, and it's a second function that we have seen just now. It carries the address and data bus. Address and data bus for memory interfacing, external memory interfacing. And these address and data bus signals are designated as AD0 to AD7. What is meaning of AD? Can anybody tell me what is meaning of AD? A means address, D means data. That means both address and data signal are multiplexed in port number 0. And it is used to connect the external memory to 8051. So what are the two functions of port 0? The first function is input output operation, that is as a IO port. And the second function is it carries the address and data signal, lower byte address and data signals. Okay. So all of you know that the width of the address for 8051 is how much? Width of the address bus for 8051 is 16 bit. Okay. So it starts from A0 to A15, isn't it? And this can be divided into 2 bytes, one from A0 to A7 and another from A8 to A15. Okay, and as all of you know, the group of 8 bits is called as a byte. So this is 1 byte, this is a second byte, and this byte is called as lower order byte, and remaining byte is called as higher order byte. Okay, port number 0 is used to carry the lower order address and data of 8051. Okay, are you clear about this, students? Or do you have any doubt in this? We are studying the ports. We have studied port number 1, which is a single function and which carries only what? Input output signals. And port number 0, it carries input output signals, but at the same time it can also perform a special function, and the special function performed by port number 0 is to carry the lower order address and data signals when external memory is connected to 8051. Are you clear about this, students? सांगा सांगा पटकन सांगा, तीनच मिनिट राहिले, सगळ्यांनी अटेंडन्स लिहायचे आहेत चॅट बॉक्स मध्ये, तुमची नाव लिहून टाका पटापट. ओके
मॅम, ते लोअर काय?
लोअर बाईट, लोअर ऑर्डर ऍड्रेस. लोअर ऑर्डर ऍड्रेस म्हणजे लोअर बाईट जो असतो ना त्याला म्हणतात लोअर ऑर्डर ऍड्रेस, आणि हायर जो बाईट असतो ना त्याला म्हणतात हायर ऑर्डर ऍड्रेस. ओके, म्हणजे मग पोर्ट 0 काय करतो? तर पोर्ट 0 लोअर ऑर्डर ऍड्रेस आणि डेटा कॅरी करतो. ओके, हे कशा फॅशन मध्ये असतात? ते मल्टिप्लेक्स्ड फॅशन मध्ये असतात. म्हणजे सुरुवातीला ऍड्रेस येतो आणि नंतर डेटा येतो. सुरुवातीला लोअर ऑर्डर ऍड्रेस येतो आणि नंतर डेटा येतो. ओके, त्याच पिनांवरती. लक्षात येत आहे? मग एएलई कशासाठी वापरतो आपण? की हा ऍड्रेस आणि डेटा सेपरेट करण्यासाठी एएलई नावाची पिन अलॉंग विथ लॅच आपल्याला वापरावी लागते. ओके, त्याला म्हणतात डी मल्टिप्लेक्सिंग. हा, इथपर्यंत लक्षात आलं सर्वांच्या? आता पोर्ट नंबर 2 चं फंक्शन पण सिंपल आहे, ते शॉर्ट मध्ये घेऊया आणि पोर्ट नंबर 3 उद्या घेऊया आपण. सो पोर्ट नंबर 2 इज ऑल्सो अ ड्युअल फंक्शन. सो ऍज इट्स डिफॉल्ट फंक्शन इज टू कॅरी द इनपुट आउटपुट सिग्नल, and its special function is to carry higher order address of 8051 when the external memory is connected to 8051. Okay, so when you are connecting external memory to 8051, port number 0 is carrying lower order address, whereas port number 2 is carrying higher order address, and along with lower order address, port 0 will carry data also. Okay, are you clear about this, students? Yes, tell me. Yes, all of you, tell me whether are you clear about this. I think we will stop here.
Yes, ma'am.
One minute is only remained, and now what I'm going to tell you is that we will have to also start communication paper, isn't it? So today when I return to home, what I will do, I will send a link of first lecture video on WhatsApp. So what you have to do is you have to watch that video. Okay, and then we will have discussion on that video, whatever you have understood or not, and if you have any doubts, I will clear. Okay,
madam.
बोला
मॅम, ह्याचे पीपीटी प्रेझेंटेशन कधी पाठवणार आहे तुम्ही?
हो, पाठवते. मग ते आजच पाठवते सगळं तुम्हाला.